Hey guys, welcome to another edition of Builds, and today we have a 2009 Volvo XC90 in the shop. What this car had done to it was pretty standard. It has a remote starter installed by us, and we also did a screen with a backup camera. Now, why I wanted to show this vehicle though was it was a little bit of a challenge to do some of the things in the vehicle, but for the most part, it was actually pretty install friendly. I swear it's almost like the Volvo engineers have the same brain as an installer, and it just starts under the hood. When you look under the hood, I always like this about Volvos. You can see here, they have a grounding point for all these devices over here. And they also do it on the other side. So it shows how much they value to have good grounds in a vehicle compared to other manufacturers. Here in the back, you see our camera install. Now, what I have to admit is it was actually fairly easy to run the camera through this vehicle. Where we were looking at it, we were kind of dreading it. But this piece right here came off quite easily. And over here was very accessible to get our reverse signal. And the batteries back here, we didn't use the battery, but I like how they placed it here. It's easy to access, easy to service, easy to change, and it's in the center, good for weight distribution. When it came to the remote starter, I thought I was going to have to fight the car quite a bit, but it actually went pretty smoothly. Going through the firewall was an issue. It looks like this vehicle was available with the manual transmission because there's a knockout plate for a master cylinder for a clutch. Also, the steering column reminds me a lot of their semi-trucks, and it came off very easily and it put back together very easily too. I've had a way harder time taking apart Honda Accords compared to this thing. Now, what I had to use for product was, I had to use a couple of things. I use a Viper Brain, and I use the old school 556 UW. There is no integration harness as far as the immobilizer goes. So it's ALCA, D-ball. No one has cracked the immobilizer on the chip key. Probably because there aren't a ton of these vehicles on the road, so they didn't develop the firmware for it. Keep in mind, when you purchase a unit like this, every firmware that you load onto it is worth about $70,000. There's a lot of R&D that goes into these things. So we just use the CA for convenience. It does our door triggers, brakes, it actually operates our locks because I didn't want to go into the door. One, you're going to have to charge the customer a lot more money to pass through that door. It's a Molex plug, and this car is mint. I don't want to muck around in the door if I don't have to, and using the integration module is going to make it work a lot better as well. So for the key wrap, you can either use a relay or you can use the module. You can actually, there's a built-in relay here, you can do your own coil. I prefer to use the 556 UW whenever I have to do a key wrap. It is significantly more reliable. I think it puts out a better signal as well. So using all three products here together, I get a seamless install, and then it remote starts very easily. And some of you might say, well, like, what do you mean a remote starts easily? It was easier for the install. In some ways, yes and no. What I mean by remote starts, I should say it works better. Because we have all these devices that I trust, and this particular install, it's going to work better. Because I've done some installs where I've used product that I'm not too familiar with, or I couldn't program it the way I wanted to, and it just wouldn't work the way I wanted to. This particular vehicle has anti-grind, for example. So on the Viper, I actually turned off engine sensing, and I just force crank it for a couple seconds because it's just not going to overcrank. But this makes sure that the car starts every time. Sometimes when you're using this brain and this brain on an older vehicle, you might get data collision and then the units get confused. Like my truck would use sometimes when I would start it, it would run for 5 minutes, it would just shut off. Reset the tach a bunch of times, doing cold weather. It wouldn't work all the time. Like 9 times out of 10, it was fine. I was getting data collision, so basically what I did was I would just turn off engine sensing on the CompuStar, and then I just cranked it for 2 seconds because it's anti-grind. You can't do that on every vehicle. Usually only newer vehicles past the 2000s you can do that. But for certain vehicles, you have to fine-tune the install to your situation. Let's check out the operation of the remote starter. So we have a one-way remote and a two-way. I prefer to just use the two-way, show you guys what's going on. So hit lock. Operates the factory security system, then our LED light goes, locks the doors obviously, hit unlock. Now in this particular vehicle, the only way to disarm the system, we have to unlock the doors, so I have it set up that way. So we're going to remote start the vehicle right now, unlocks the doors. And then locks them right away. Now you have to do that on certain vehicles. Certain vehicles, it is the only way to operate the factory alarm. Otherwise, if we don't do that, then the horn honks and then obviously it's not working that well. So if you think it's kind of weird, there are vehicles we have to set up that way. The XC90 is interesting because it has a mounting kit, but it does not have any wiring harness available for it or antenna adapter. So we had to use a universal antenna from Metra. That's right up there. And on the other side, if you guys want to see the rest of the install, see our Bluetooth mics over there, and then we have our antenna for our Viper. So there is an amplifier here under the seat, which isn't unheard of, but the way it's done is so nice. 310 mils, pops right out, tons of room in there. I swear these guys were installers. So we had to tag all our signal. Now the catch when you're doing a vehicle like this, Volvo runs the SRS system through the head unit. So I actually have the factory head unit in there and we had to plug everything back in. So all the fiber optics, all the plugs are plugged back in. That way you can cycle through the system. If you don't believe me, try doing one of these decks without having any of that stuff in there and see what messages you get on the dash. So we actually have that all in here. We have no messages on the dash. Everything works fine. So that was the challenge. We had to bring our speaker lines. You can actually bring them up or bring them back down. I brought them down here. So I found all my speaker lines to drive the whole system. And it actually sounds pretty good off that Pioneer head unit. The nice things about the Pioneer are you can actually customize the splash screen. So I usually just change it to whatever vehicle it is. That way it looks more factory. Customer can always change it to whatever they want afterwards. I also try to change the illumination lights to be similar to what you would see on the cluster, and also by the HVAC controls, just to give it that look that's supposed to be there, as opposed to like, well, that's blue and this is a weird green. So we just put in reverse. And the way that we typically set up cameras in the shop now is it's on a relay. A lot of these vehicles, especially the ones with modules, that accessory line does not have that much, it doesn't have strong voltage or that much amperage going on. So I know these cameras are low draw, but I want to make sure that we have good consistent voltage. So I usually put it on a relay on a good source. I'll even just grab power off of here. But the other reason I want it on a relay to turn on the camera is because I don't want the camera running all the time. I only want it to be on when the reverse light turns on. And you should never power up cameras off the reverse light because the voltage is very weak and you can get really weird performance. So that's why I use relays. I've noticed that, especially in the cold months, that I don't have any warranties come back because of that. So it's the little extra step we take. You as the customer will probably not see it, but you know, keep in mind, you know, it's peace of mind knowing that we do steps like that. So this Metra dash kit fits really nicely. Clearance is good. I'm always concerned about that. So no issues with the CD drive door opening or closing. We do have Android Auto on here as well. Our USB cable and auxiliary are in the glove box. Another thing, like, it's a sealed glove box, but I had enough room to run it without that much trouble. Again, like, Volvo vehicles, I'm just in awe because I haven't worked on too many. They are designed to be serviced. They're designed to be worked on. It doesn't look like it because you're like, oh, great, another European car is going to be like a Volkswagen or a Mercedes, just like kind of hard to take apart unless you've done a ton of them. And no, first time in, comes apart really well. So let's go take a look. Built-in navigation. This particular one, I hit the antenna under the dash. Pretty standard setup that you would see in most fully featured head units. Again, another thing that I like in head units like this, I just use the presets typically, is for listening position, I like to set it up for the driver. And it does actually, it's time delay. So it makes it seem like you're centered in the vehicle because the driver is probably the person that invested the most money into the vehicle as far as installing this. I'm going to set it up best for them. But yeah, we have upgraded safety with the camera, navigation, plus the added features of Android Auto or Apple CarPlay, depending on which phone you have. And it actually sounds better, even though we bypassed the factory amp, I think it sounds a little bit better. I would love to hear this thing though with a sub in it. So what do you guys think of this vehicle? Would you update this? It is a perfectly good running vehicle. Would you update it with some of the latest and greatest features? Or would you rather buy something new that kind of has most of these things, but maybe you're buying more than you need? Comment below, I'd like to know.
If you like today's content, make sure to check out my channel and hit the subscribe button and make sure to hit that bell notification. What that does is it makes sure that you're always kept up to date with all the content that we're providing with you guys on YouTube. So the way that we have the channel set up is I have the uploads up top. That way, at all times, you can always see, if you just hop by the channel, what our latest upload is. Plus, with the bell notification, you're going to get some sort of message from YouTube itself. We also have popular uploads, car videos, how-to videos, demonstration and informational videos, and a lot of cool other specific car videos like our builds playlist. I really like the builds playlist because it takes all the theories from our how-to section, and it keeps applying it to different vehicles.